here to see Brainwreck Improv because that's what you're going to be here seeing now. If we see you leave, we hold a grudge for a very long time. I'm going to be hosting our first game, but for that first game, we're going to need some improvisers out on stage. So first, let me welcome Kaya Bolin to the stage. Next, we'll add a little bit of Steve Callen to the mix. We'll sprinkle in some Ricky Mystery. Dash of Greg Nero here. And now for his debut with Brainwreck Improv, we are going to add some Valen Krestowski to the mix. So, in total, we make up a Brainwreck Improv stew. And first off, we're going to play a little bit of a game for you. Just one. Followed by others. So this game is one we lovingly call the Jonton game, and for that we might need some suggestions from you. So how many of you have been to an improv show before and know how to give suggestions? I will take them. You'll give suggestions to me. These are the people who have been to an improv show before.
Yeah.
I specifically changed it up because we always have people who lie. We still have people who lie here, but I think we have some new people too, which is always great to have. So, when we ask you for a suggestion tonight, as we will do a few times, you're going to, we'll either ask you to raise your hand if it's a little bit longer of a suggestion, or you'll just shout something out in a category. So for this game, I would say, give me a name, just any name.
Britney Spears!
Lange Blodge. Okay, Lange Blodge. And now for this game, we're going to take whatever name we heard. Lange Blodge.
What part of that is what name?
What's the first name?
Lange. We might take a more realistic name. I really hope that's not. I might be insulting someone if that is a real person.
Great.
But we would like a real person's name for this game.
Did I hear Jeremy Jordan?
I heard Jeremy Jordan. And once I've heard a suggestion, we'll stop for a little bit in between suggestions. So, Jeremy Jordan?
Yeah.
Awesome. Jeremy Jordan, thank you so much.
If Jeremy Jordan played basketball, he'd be Michael Jordan. If Jeremy Jordan had a problem where he liked to collect a lot of things and not give anything away, he'd be Jeremy Horton. If Jeremy Jordan showed up drunk to his hotel, he'd be Carry Me, Dorman.
If Jeremy Jordan was a cussing lady of the night, he'd be Swearing Horton.
If Jeremy Jordan were a poorly regulated prison, he'd be nary a warden.
If Jeremy Jordan was some sort of peasant whose overlord's name was Norman, he would be on his knees begging sympathy, Norman. If Jeremy Jordan wasn't such a nothing, low life, who nobody knew, he'd be very important.
Can we get another name?
Sam Ellis!
All right, we'll do Sam Ellis because it was really loud and I'm also very tempted to do that.
If Sam Ellis were a nice garden decoration made out of meat, it should be ham trellis.
Cool.
If Sam Ellis was dating Lucas Jordan, she'd be Sam Ellis. Important context. Sam Ellis was a person that lived in the underworld, they'd be Sam Hellish.
If Sam Ellis lived in the sea, he'd be Clam Shellis.
If Sam Ellis was being interrogated, she'd be Sam, tell us!
If Sam Ellis was something that Gary Coleman's character said in Different Strokes, I think, should be, damn, Willis.
If Sam Ellis was being interrogated by the good cop, it would be more like, bam, tell us.
Sam Ellis was a poisoned can of spiced ham, she'd be spam, kill us.
If Sam Ellis was a person who like was fully aware that a telemarketer was trying to, you know, pull a fast one on her, but like wanted to see where it was going, she'd say, scam, sell us.
If Sam Ellis was walking one day and slipped on something and it fell and broke their tailbone, they'd have a slammed pelvis.
If Sam Ellis was a 90s, I think like late 90s genie, she would be Shazam Ellis.
If a group of people asked Sam Ellis what war she fought in, she'd say, ma'am, fellas.
If Sam Ellis was telling a story to a bunch of middle schoolers, they'd say, fam, tell us.
Can we get some names of maybe some famous people? This wonderful person is raising their hand. Okay.
So he plays for the New York Jets, Jermaine Pearley.
Jermaine Pearley?
Yeah, Pearley, like his name.
Is it Jermaine or Jemaine?
I don't really know.
This is important. Jermaine Pearley?
Yes.
Jermaine Pearley.
Okay, Jermaine Pearley. Thank you.
If Jermaine Curley worked out a lot, he'd be Jermaine Burley.
If Jermaine Curley was one of the Three Stooges, he'd be Jermaine Moe.
If Jermaine Curley were one of those busty women who serve beer at Oktoberfest, he'd be a German girly.
Jermaine Curley was some sort of grammar expert that was teaching their children. He'd be like, you know what the word surly means. Someone threw up their salad, they'd be Romaine Hurley.
If Jermaine Curley was introducing you to a lady friend of his, he might be like, oh, her name's Shirley.
If Jermaine Curley were a superhero that defeated people with a gaseous container, his name would be Propane Fury.
If Jermaine Curley was a whirlpool technician for like a hot tub company, and he was really getting frustrated with fixing this thing, it'd be Romaine Whirly.
Jermaine Curley was in a Chinese restaurant and he was mixing up his noodles, he'd be Lo Ming Swirly.
Can we get the name of maybe some fictional characters? Possibly like Let's go with Willy Wonka.
Yeah.
That seems to be one that people
want. If Willy Wonka were a clown, he'd be Silly Honka.
If Willy Wonka was a lake, he'd be Minnetonka. If Willy Wonka were a landscape in a foreign country, it'd be hilly Sri Lanka.
If Willy Wonka were a corporate stooge, he would be Shilly Wonka.
If Willy Wonka had the thing where he like always tipped over something to drink, he'd be Spilly Wonka.
If Willy Wonka was at a bar getting sloshed, but he had a comical Italian accent, he would say, "I'm really drunk."
If Willy Wonka was showing signs of pregnancy, and everyone was kind of curious, it would be, "Is she knocked up?"
After a lot of drinking, Willy Wonka might turn to something harder and become Pill I Want 'em.
Oh, if Willy Wonka was an expert at whack-a-mole, he'd be Willy Bonka. If Willy Wonka were an elderly man that had grandchildren, and he was also Greek maybe, and he grew plants, he would be Chickpea Grandpa.
Let's do a god. Let's name a deity.
God.
Zeus! God! Hercules!
Poseidon!
Poseidon! Aphrodite! Hermes!
Hermes?
Hermes?
Hermes? Hermes?
Okay. This is a totally original joke that's never been thought of, ever. But if Hermes was some sort of infection or disease, one might say he's herpes.
If Hermes were an infection or disease that kids wouldn't say, he might be Germes.
If Hermes was an excuse for a really horny middle schooler to not do well in school, he'd tell a teacher, "Her knees."
If he were a document signed by someone with their landlord, he'd be her lease.
Oh. If Hermes was an uncle that just absolutely loved everyone in his family, he'd be sure, niece.
If Hermes was a collection of metal equipment that he used to wheel people around, he'd be gurneys.
If Hermes was a word that he used to describe the worms, perhaps, or other worm-like things, he'd be squirmy.
If Hermes was the voice of your GPS, he'd be, "Turn, please."
If Hermes went to a bar to pick up chicks, he'd be like, "Her, please."
All right, we're going to call it there.
All right, folks. So for our next game, we're actually going to need two brave volunteers from the crowd. And I'm going to move out of the headlights here so I can actually see what the hell's going on. We're going to need two people, preferably with no improv experience.
Is there someone over there?
Okay, wait for me. Someone
over here?
No, okay, wait.
All right.
Up here.
All right.
He's
your
mom right now.
Yeah,
any
more? Yeah, I'm serious. I haven't been on a trip.
All right.
Clint, the sort of guy you better represent
today. So this game is called Puppets. Appropriately, come up on stage.
So, the premise of this game is that the improvisers that are up on stage from Brainwreck will be using their voices, but the people that we've chosen for the audience will be controlling their actions. So, for example, say, what's your name?
Vlad.
Vlad, if you want to come over here and control Steve, which is Dan. Quinn, come over here, you get to control what Kaya does. So this is how it's going to work. If you want to control their arms, you kind of like tap them on the elbow like this.
Grab them. Grab my wrist.
Go ahead, go for
them. And move them.
Yeah, if you want them to go forward, tap their legs like that in the back. It's kind of like the same idea. If you want to move their heads, just be respectful, please. Okay, so, and for this scene, we're going to need a suggestion of a non-food thing.
Freeze away! The challenge!
Right there, right there. What?
Cleveland Indians.
Okay, Cleveland Indians. Alright, so, see you now.
You know, I'm really not getting the hang of the wave.
No, I just...
Is it side to side?
I think it's up and down.
Like this?
Hold on, I need to get a little closer to the stadium. No, you see, the sun. These are really bad seats, Matilda.
I'm sorry, I could only get the nosebleed ones. Lose my balance.
Can't even see what's happening. Have they?
Whoa! Wow, the are you wind okay there? Is really strong up here.
I can't really look at you. My eyes are glued to the game.
It's captivating, isn't it?
See, wow! Oh my God! Did you
wow.
see that?
I did.
Did you see that?
What a
snap!
What a wow!
Wow! I've never seen a display like this before.
I'm so emotional right now. Oh my God.
Hold on, let me move over to you, past these,
I can't look.
These three people that are sorry. Sorry. Matilda. Thank you so much for taking me to the Super Bowl.
Anytime. I might have had a little too much to drink.
Oh boy, me too. Oh no.
Oh no. What you get?
They just give you so much beer at the stage. Oh my God.
Wow.
Oh, we're probably so obnoxious to the people
you know,
standing
that is probably. You know, I don't even know which team is playing right now. I'm going to be honest with you. Just here for the beer.
Is that the Eagles there?
I thought they played football.
I don't even know anymore.
It's here to enjoy yourself. Enjoy the whole experience.
Yeah, you're right.
Frank, I'm really glad you came with me today. I still can't get the hang of the wave, but I'm really glad you're here.
You mean that?
I mean that.
I still can't look at you because, God, this game is so interesting.
It's
I love football.
Same.
Matilda,
yes.
High five me right now.
Okay.
And can we get one more round of applause for our audience?
All right. It's time to get serious, guys. It's time to get real serious. But first, I want to do some ASMR shit, like, if I just, like, breathe into the microphone for a bit. Is everyone going to be comfortable with that? Just, like, a little... Can I do anything for you? Okay. The rest of Brainwreck's tired of my bullshit. So, we're going to be playing a game called Serious Scene.
And the thing about a serious scene is that it's serious. So, we need... a serious suggestion from you guys.
Operation.
Divorce! Leaving the home! I'm not talking like normal serious stuff. I'm talking like real fucked up. Okay?
We're playing the pressure.
Stop my circle!
start the scene.
Well, John, it looks like I'm gonna have to get my toes cut off there.
Look, I'm with you. All right, all the way. I'm going to be with you the entire time.
I don't even know how I got frostbite on my toes.
You don't know how?
I mean, we live in Florida. I thought I took all the precautions.
Socks aren't enough. You have to wear shoes too.
Well, look, toes aren't the worst thing you could lose. You can live without toes.
I'm scared.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm scared too. But when's the last time you heard of someone bleeding out over their toes?
I don't know, I'm sure it's happened. Dave, I know this is going to be tough for you, and you're probably going to have to...
My name's Deborah.
Deborah.
Jesse, I...
Deborah, it's not going to be that bad.
It's not going to be that bad. I'm losing a part of my body.
Well, 10 parts.
I don't see how you're as upset at this as I am.
Well, I'm about to lose my toes. Why should I be upset? Deborah, I'm your friend. I'm going to be here for you, okay? And so, yes, it's tough, but I'm here to help you through it. That's why I'm not going crazy. I just want to be here to support you. Because you're not going to be able to go back to the automotive plant. And most grocery stores require cashiers to be standing at all times, especially in the U.S., so labor laws will fuck you there.
whatever happens, I'm here to support you, all right? Through thick and thin. If you need some recovery time afterwards, I'll pick up double shifts and I'll get groceries for you. This is about you and what you need here.
I just have one request.
Anything.
Can I have half of your toes?
I just have one request. Can we go out for ice cream after this? What are we here with you?
Look, you know I prefer frozen yogurt.
Deborah, that's how you lost your toes in the first
place. This time of winter?
Not a great idea, Deborah.
You're right. Can we go out for some hot soup?
Yeah, I'm just really nervous about the surgery now. I don't know if it's gonna go well.
Yeah, I've never had someone chop off my toes either.
How do you find out about something like that?
Yeah, I guess it shouldn't be too bad, right? They'll
probably
put you under and then take your toes. I'm sure it's not that bad. They're professionals. They've studied years and practiced years.
You think?
Yeah, you're gonna be fine.
Okay, that makes me feel a lot better.
Right.
So, you know, I just want to be able to be normal. You know, like how's this gonna?
Ooh.
Everything
sure?
You're gonna be fine.
Okay. Thanks. I just, you know, I want to be able to run around and play and stuff, like I used to. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do that. Do I have to get like a size smaller and chew? Like, how does this work? Yeah, I just can't wait for this winter to be over and I can wear my favorite pair of open-toed shoes.
Take a look at the shoes. They're gonna put me in afterward for the therapy.
Yeah?
God, they're ugly. They're like these clog things. I mean, I know that's kind of trivial because, like, you know, I'm losing my toes, but it's important.
I believe you.
I want to feel normal and I want to feel, you know, like I can wear what I want. I also might tip forward, so I guess it's good.
I guess I'm just nervous about what life will be like afterwards, you know?
I'm sure.
Do you think people would treat me different afterwards, or would they not notice if I just keep hiding it? I don't know. Are you going to keep hanging around me after?